Twiggy with Marilyn Manson. You're watching Nerve TV. My interpretation of the title, the high and the low, would be just how low can you get with something? It's just like it's the how dark and how more fucked up can things get possibly be, you know, and how much torture can you put yourself through? Death to the ladies first, then the gentlemen, all sorts of taxi facelifts, abortion, nervous breakdancing. Recording this album, at least when I was writing the music for it, there really wasn't an idea or a direction or anything. It just kind of came out naturally. And I don't want to speak for Manson, but from what I witnessed, this was the first time that I've seen him just kind of walk into a project and not use any of the lyrics that he had prior to it. He actually had lost his lyric book with all the lyrics that he was working on, so he was kind of forced into just coming up with stuff that he was going through at the moment. And I think what he was going through on in his life during the recording of the record reflected in the final product. As it progressed, it was obvious that what was working was for it to be organic and not like overproduced and just kind of like there's nothing that has to be recreated, because there's only two guitar parts or one guitar part instead of being like 10 guitar tracks or all this stuff that's impossible for a band to play. So anything on this record can be recreated by the live band, which is why the stuff sounds the best live too. Working with A Perfect Circle and Nine Inch Nails, I learned a lot. You know, I definitely came back a better musician. I don't think it has to do with either of those bands. It just has to do with playing with other people. Probably learned most actually working with Chris Goth. Because we have a side band called Goo Moon together, and I learned a lot about how his recording methods are just he's not too meticulous about what he does. It's just like put a mic in front of something and record it. It's not like there's not too much of an art to it. It's just very, very basic, and I kind of use that with recording this album. Just like kind of just, because nothing ever sounds better if the more time you spent on it, it just sounds different, you know. I mean, I think the real world is a little more dangerous than Marilyn Manson is, the band. You know, it's like the real life is scarier than what we do. Is I think, again, Manson's always just been kind of the more fucked up the world is, the more things I think Manson has to talk about. So it's like he's just a reflection of what's going on. So I think, the world has gotten more dangerous, so has Marilyn Manson. Yeah. I've honestly become so desensitized to the whole thing that I don't even really pay attention to it anymore. I just want to make music and do my thing.